Faith and Friends time. Welcome to another brand new show. We're thankful to spend the next 30 minutes with you, our friends. We're now more than halfway through the month of February, and I have a confession to make. My Christmas lights are still up.
I know. We've been tracking
my nativity scenes are still up, and my snow fan collection is still up.
Do you still turn the lights on at night?
Well, they're on a timer, so yes, they do come on at night.
I think a Christmas tree without lights on is kind of depressing.
It's not a tree.
It's not a tree.
It's the lights on my outside of my house. Well, yes.
You know what, though? Honestly, we need to celebrate Christmas 365 days a year. So there's absolutely nothing wrong with still having your Christmas decorations up.
Thank you.
Now, having a snowman collection, that might be another story.
Hey, you know what?
What about the Christmas
music?
We
are in Ohio, and it snows, and it's nice, and it snows. I'm just preparing for the next thing of snow. Christmas music, I have retired that.
But I want to celebrate every day.
Well, moving from Christmas celebrations to birthday celebrations, coming up in today's show, we introduce you to 100-year-old Mozelle Saylor. Also look at recent Night to Shine special needs prom at Lima First Assembly of God, and more tips from Dr. Trudy Pieper on ways for women to increase their energy. But first, today's scripture.
Always a good way to increase anyone's energy is by turning to the Word of God. And today we go to the book of Matthew, chapter 4, verses 12 through 17. Now when Jesus heard that John had been put in prison, he departed to Galilee. And leaving Nazareth, he came and dwelt in Capernaum, which is by the sea, in the regions of Zebulun and Naphtali, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by Isaiah the prophet, saying, the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali, by the way of the sea, beyond the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles, the people who sat in darkness have seen a great light. And upon those who sat in the region and shadow of death, light has dawned. From that time, Jesus began to preach and to say, repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Jesus had so much love in all of his presentations. He wanted to heal people, but he was always asking them to change their lives and to turn from the selfish, sinful ways and to follow him. That repentance is such a key.
Absolutely, and that is our focus right now in our 2017 Faith Challenge, repentance. When we can come before God and admit our own wrongs, our own faults, and allow him to clean us from that, that is a door opener to be able to do so many other important things. Freedom in our lives is necessary for just daily living.
Well, at Lima Baptist Temple, she's affectionately known to many as Grandma, especially by the Awana Cubbies kids who spend every Wednesday evening with her at church. And this lovable, lively, encouraging woman recently turned 100 years old. Jennifer has more in today's OIO in the Community Spotlight.
Well, you know, today it seems like everyone is so busy, and a lot of times it's hard to find workers. And when I asked Lenore Herps if she would be willing to help me this year, she said, well, you know, where I go, Granny goes. And that is her grandmother who lives with her. And I had no idea how old she was till she started working, and I couldn't believe when I heard that she was in her 90s. And she has helped me now several years, and last year we celebrated her 99th birthday, and so pleased that God saw fit for her to live another year, and now we're celebrating her 100th birthday.
That was February 8th, Mozelle Saylor's 100th birthday. And who better to celebrate with than the 3 and 4-year-old kids who come to the Awana Cubbies program at Lima Baptist Temple. Every Wednesday night, these little ones get to learn from the one who's seen a lot. They call her Granny, and she helps them with crafts, Bible verses, and so much more. Why does Mozelle want to be an Awana helper? Church has always been a part of her life, and she thinks it should be the same for these kids.
My mom says how her grandmother would go and get her, walk clear across town, and get her grandkids, and would take them to Sunday school and church. So we just don't, church is just part of our life.
Northwest Ohio has also always been a part of Mozelle's life. She was born in Wood County and eventually found herself in Lima.
I was born in Bloomdale, and then Daddy had a bake shop there. And then we moved to Dunkirk, and over 70 years or more, the folks owned the house. But Then when I married, then I came to Lima. That was in June of 41.
Now, February of 2017, Northwest Ohio is still Mozelle's home, and Lima Baptist Temple is appreciative for her desire to continue serving the Lord.
She has been such a blessing with the children. I mean, she just is in her own quiet self and will do anything for these kids, and they love her too.
Time now to move to another definition of incredible. Well, you've heard us talk about the Niswonger time and time again here on Faith and Friends. And this year is quite a significant year for the Performing Arts Center. It's being called 10 Years of Wow. That's right, this is the 10th season celebration. It's hard to believe that it has been an entire decade that we have been blessed by the Niswonger Performing Arts Center and all that it does to give back to the community. And the man who's been a part of that since the beginning joins us today. The Executive Director, Paul Hoverman, is here. Paul, first of all, congratulations on 10 years.
Thanks, Jennifer.
Fabulous. Yeah. What a blessing, not just for Van Wert, but for the entire Northwest Ohio region.
Well, that's what we had hoped for when we first opened up back in 2007, that we could bring the arts to the region and bring entertainment, education, and inspiration.
Well, I can say you've definitely done that, and you've done so in really a family-friendly focus. I mean, you've created an event center that it just enriches Northwest Ohio.
Yeah, well, thank you. That's, you know, we have a good board, and I have an excellent staff. And our mission has always been to try to keep family entertainment at our Performing Arts Center. We want things that people feel they can be safe in coming to, bringing their children and just adults. And I think we've been blessed in many ways.
So this 10th year, this 10-year of wow season has had some incredible performers and speakers already come mm-hmm. through the area. And there's a lot of great things yet coming up, getting close to the end of the season, but it's
right.
A big shebang is yet
right.
to come.
It is. We're going to be celebrating on April 1st, and that's no fooling. but we are having our 10-year gala celebration. And I thought we should have a big celebration for 10 years. Who knows when the next big celebration will be, so let's make it as big as we can. And so I was checking around with a lot of different agents to see who might be a great gala performer, and the name Bernadette Peters kept coming up. And of course, she's been, you know, huge on Broadway and in movies and on TV, very recognizable and an excellent singer. And just a great personality. So we wanted to fit her with an orchestra because that's how she performs the best. And one thing led to another, and I ended up calling Mr. Niswonger and told him that I wanted to create a kind of Boston Pops feel to the evening where people could come and socialize and make it a classy evening. And Scott Niswonger, being himself, said, well, how much would the Boston Pops be? And I had never thought that we would go that far. One thing led to another, and here we are on April 1st with the Boston Pops, Keith Lockhart conducting, and they'll do the first half, and it'll be a Gershwin half with An American in Paris, and then Rhapsody in Blue. They have a piano soloist that'll be with them, and then Bernadette comes out and does the second half mm-hmm. to help us celebrate.
Now, you guys always do everything in style. Every time I'm there, I'm always impressed with the little extras that you have just to make people feel welcome and feel like they're in a classy environment. But this one's going to be stepped up a little bit, isn't it?
Well, it certainly will be. The lobby will be certainly decorated like it's never been decorated before. We have a great visual arts committee and some ladies and some guys that are a part of that. And they have some great things in store. So the whole place will be transformed into a beautiful performing arts hall. And the kind of night that we wanted to create was, like I said, a classy night. It's an optional black tie mm-hmm. event. So you can wear your tux if you would like mm-hmm. and your gowns. However, if you don't want to and don't feel that comfortable, come as you are. But we do want it to be a nice evening of celebration.
And there are tickets still available for this, right?
There are a few tickets left yet.
All right. Now, notice he said a few tickets, which means the now would be the time for you to move forward and purchase those tickets so you can make those grand plans to be part of this gala celebration on April 1st. There's the box office number on the screen. 419-238-6722 is the box office number. Mm-hmm. And it's not just the gala that's coming up yet. A lot of other things. In fact, before the gala, let's talk about coming up this week. We have Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood, and then you have Artrageous coming up soon too.
Right. Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood. We have two performances on this Saturday, and I think they are at 11 a.m. and 2 p.m. So with two performances, we can get a lot of people in there. Mm-hmm. There are still tickets available, and of course, Daniel Tiger's Neighborhood is probably known to all kids, maybe grandparents and parents. A great teaching lesson, kids' story. Taken kind of from Mr. Rogers' neighborhood, which we're familiar with, and I know a lot of your listeners are too. But this is kind of like the cartoon version, and this will be the live stage production. So it should be a wonderful kids show.
Oh, and you mentioned grandparents. What a fun outing for your grandchildren. What a fun thing to be able to do. Not overly costly, yet in a fun environment. So there's the correct box office number right there on the screen. And then Artrageous, before we started the interview, Paul, we were talking about how unique and interesting this is going to be, yet because it's unknown to the region, mm-hmm. they don't really realize this little gem that's coming.
Right,
this
right.
is going to be a fun event.
Well, I think it is. The name Artrageous got my attention because we, for a number of years, have had an Artrageous festival over in Van Wert the first weekend in June. So when I saw this email about Artrageous, it got my attention right away. And I started watching video of it and talking to them about it. And I thought, what a unique concept and entertaining concept, combining visual art with performing art, because there will be a live band on stage performing music of all across the spectrum of from like Frank Sinatra to Ray Charles and the Beatles and all kinds of things in between. There's Santana, and while they're performing that music, there will be huge canvases on stage with artists who are painting pictures of those artists they are singing from.
Great, so that is coming up on March 11th, 7:30 p.m., and you can purchase tickets for that either online or you can call the box office. We are just about out of time. There are a lot of great things. You can, of course, go to the website anytime to get up-to-date information on the things that are happening at the Niswonger, but we do have one more concert that definitely hits our viewers, and that is David Phelps, and mm-hmm. that one is selling very quickly as well.
That one, you better get tickets right now. Every day we're selling more, and we are getting close to a sellout with David Phelps. The Phelps people actually called us and said, we would love to, after Christmas last year, we would love to bring a Good Friday service to you. Mm-hmm. And you can imagine some of the powerful music from Good Friday that David Phelps can bring. It's going to be a very memorable night.
Wonderful. Okay, like Paul said, purchase your tickets now for that one. That is expected to sell out, and you certainly don't want to miss it. The box office phone number again is 419-238-6722, and the website NPACVW, that's NPACVW.org. Well, 3 years ago, Lima First Assembly of God was one of only about 24 locations across the country who was hosting a Tim Tebow Foundation Night to Shine. This year, as more churches across the country were chosen to participate in the program, Lima First remained the spot for the event in Northwest Ohio. This year, more than 130 registrants enjoyed a night of dining, socializing, dancing, and realizing just how important and valuable they truly are to those around them. More than 300 volunteers from Lima First, surrounding churches, Ohio Northern University, and UNOH gathered February 10th to give these kids a storybook night. Lima First Pastor Randy Davis says due to the expansion of the nationwide program, less funding money was available to help churches like Lima First make this event possible. But that was never the focus behind Lima First's involvement. And Davis says now, 3 years in, they consider hosting this event an amazing chance to work together as a community and to make a difference in the lives of many, key elements to being the hands and feet of Jesus.
Our church is fully vested that this is a great investment in our community. The greatest thing that happens when your people work well together And we were just talking about how so many people are here, and for one cause, they're working together and they're having a blast. And there's nothing better for me to watch than that. I think last year we had just under 100, so we're up quite a few. We increased the age a little bit, and that helped. So it's up to 30 years old, the guests that are coming. And got about 350 volunteers, and then all the parents and caregivers.
Pastor Randy says attendees came from as far north as Toledo and as far south as Troy to attend this year's Night to Shine event. This year, the program grew to 350 locations in 50 states and 11 different countries. Well, time now for part three in our Vows to Keep series on marriage and the Ten Commandments. David and Tracy Sellers dive into Commandments 6 and 7, Thou shalt not kill and thou shalt not commit adultery, two obvious necessities in regards to a healthy marriage. But the Sellers say there's even more to comprehend than just what's obvious.
Ten Commandments really can make a difference in our marriage.
They sure can. And I actually want to start today by reading out of Luke chapter 11. This is verse 28. Jesus says, but even more blessed are all those who hear the word of God and put it into practice. And I think as we read the Ten Commandments and we realize how practical they are, this is a meaningful verse. It's important sometimes to look at your life and ask the question, am I seeing some gaping holes? Is there places that I'm missing some of that blessing that I think God would have for me? God's word tells us that we will be blessed when we do what he asks of us, when we're faithful to that. And Jesus makes it very clear that he will love us no matter what, but by obeying these commandments, we're going to see some great fruit. I think it's interesting as we look at the Ten Commandments, how simple and how applicable they are. Going back to the greatest commandment, I'm going to read out of Mark 12. Jesus highlights the most important commandment is this. Listen, O Israel, the Lord our God is the one and only Lord. And you must love the Lord our God with all your heart, all of your soul, all of your mind, and all of your strength. The second is equally important. Love your neighbor as yourself. No other commandment is greater than these.
I love that. I'm so thankful that Jesus boils down what he wants for us right here in these sentences. It's really short and sweet. It's not complicated. We don't need to make it complicated. He's saying, love me as the only God. Make me number one. Love me with all you have, and then reach out and love to others the same way that you would want to be loved. The Ten Commandments, some people would say, are outdated because they're in the Old Testament, but I'd like to argue with that because Jesus actually specifically talks about 9 of them in the New Testament. He makes it clear that these are still important. They're still relevant today.
Well, last week on Faith and Friends, we did discuss the first 5 commandments. And if you have missed that episode, you can certainly go to faithandfriends.wtlw.com. And you can see last week's episode with the first 5 commandments. But now we're going to jump into number 6. And goodness gracious, when we're talking about marriage, thou shalt not murder.
Yeah, a lot of times we would just want to laugh that one off, right? That doesn't seem like that is, Lord help us if that applies. But you know what? There's probably times when it does apply. When we get married, we start out by saying, oh, I love this person. This is just not one of those thoughts that goes through our head. But we've all had those moments where we're literally screaming our heads off at our spouse. And we're effectively killing our marriage with those words. It's murderous to our relationship, some of the things that we can say.
James chapter 4 talks about this. It says, you want what you don't have, so you scheme and you kill to get it. You're jealous, you can't get it, so you fight and you wage war to take it away from them. But you don't have what you want because you don't ask God. And then when we ask with the wrong motives because we just want it for our own selfish pleasure. It says it right there. We don't get what we want, so we're willing to kill our marriage in this situation.
There's the murder right
to get
there.
It.
Yeah,
it's
exactly.
Not the murder that we instantly think about. There are other ways that we can break this commandment in our marriage.
Definitely.
Yeah. I mean, effectively, if we were to think about this in terms of our marriage, the death of a marriage is effectively a divorce. And in divorce, the process of this death is something that's not quick. It's usually very painful, very slow. And the good part about that is that a lot of times you can recover from that. But most marriages, they're killed over the course of many, many years and lots of pain, lots of agony. So even if it's been something that you see that's years in the coming, there's almost always this point in time in which there's a spouse that gives that final cut, that final thing that just seems to kill it. And you can do that through your actions and through the thoughts that you have. You can kill the friendship in your marriage. You can kill the passion. You can kill the love. You can kill all these different aspects of your marriage. But Jesus came to give us life and to give us love and to do those things, to apply those things into our marriages. We find that with the greatest commandment, he says, love the Lord and love your neighbor as yourself. Now, this is like the closest neighbor we've got, right? Yeah. So you can be confident that if you're going to apply what you've read here, you will not be someone who's going to murder your marriage.
One way that that can happen is through adultery. And it can be physical, emotional, in your mind. And that's actually the seventh commandment. You shall not commit adultery. So we have to look at what that word actually means. Well, adultery is anytime we seek union with someone outside of our covenant relationship.
Yeah, there's a lot of times where, you know, you might be a guy who's looking at pornography and you think to yourself, you know, well, this isn't as serious as actually having an affair. Well, I would argue that in Matthew 5, Jesus says basically, you should not commit adultery, but I say that whoever looks on a woman with lust has already committed adultery with her. So you're trying to unify yourself with someone who's in a picture. And for some reason, for a lot of guys, that seems like it's less dangerous. But it is not less dangerous. It's basically like seeking out prostitution, but without having the money invested in it, right? You've committed the sin, the damage is done. And this is why this command is here.
And for women, it can be emotional affairs. It might not be pornography for them, but they're still trying to unite themselves with someone outside of their marriage. They're giving part of themselves to another that's not their spouse. And I think this commandment is very similar to the first commandment that we talked about last time, which is to have no other gods before you. And in a marriage relationship, that's a singular relationship. We should have no other relationship outside of that that's as equal in importance. And I think in this situation, to have adultery not creep into your marriage slowly, put in some ground rules in a place, put in some boundaries, and talk about, hey, let's share the same passwords. I want you to have access to my phone. I want this to be out in the open. And really, this commandment is for the protection of our marriage. Yeah. This is God's loving us, saying, adhere to this commandment, and it's going to be a safety net for your marriage.
The final commandments and their positive impact on marriage coming up next week in our final installment of our series with Vows to Keep Marriage Ministries. Now, to reach Vows to Keep directly, visit them online at vowstokeep.com. Well, now on to another ongoing series this month, Natural Ways to Increase Energy for Women. Dr. Trudy Pieper returns with more natural health options that could be the needed components to add pep to your step.
Now, there's another pain option that you suggest that starts with a B.
It does. It's Boswellia. And Boswellia is a unique pain remedy because of its ability to affect a certain pathway of inflammation. It's called 5-LOX, and it's found in chronic diseases like arthritis. If you have osteoarthritis or rheumatoid arthritis, you'll hear your doctor talk about there's a pathway to pain to do that. And again, NSAIDs are usually prescribed for that. Boswellia will go in and actually stop that pathway so that the pain, you don't feel the pain from that. So it blocks it. It's also good for irritable bowel syndrome and all autoimmune diseases.
Wow.
So it improves, and it basically what it does is what NSAIDs do are improve the blood flow. The more blood you have flowing, that's what aspirin does. Aspirin improves the blood flow, and the more blood flow, the less pain you have.
So here are options. This is the thing to remember. You have options. There are things other than just those prescription drugs that you've been provided. I'm not asking you to throw those away. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't just suddenly change your doctor's orders. But, you know, let's think about these things that God has provided and look to someone like Dr. Trudy, who can give you some other options that provide some of these natural things that our bodies are just more designed for.
Right.
Now, the next thing you're going to talk about, though, God has given these to us, and we women have messed up ones left and right, up and down. We're talking about hormones.
Hormones, and talk about an energy zapper. If you have PMS, you know, you are, your energy is low, you're combating all the signs, you're heavy bleeding, you're having cramping, you feel irritable, you're moody, all those things. And then you go to the other end of the spectrum and you have menopausal symptoms. So hormones can really affect your body and your energy. And I'd just like to suggest, you know, one thing that I know for sure makes a big difference on either end of that spectrum. And it's something we call DIM, D-I-M, and it's dienolylmethane. That's quite a mouthful. It's actually made, again, we talk about God's plan for plants, cruciferous vegetables. So if you buy DIM, it's like eating 100 broccoli in each pill.
Oh, really?
And the cruciferous vegetables, what they do is they rid the body of excess estrogens. PMS symptoms are caused by having too much estrogen in your body. And so removing those will make a big difference in helping you feel better during your PMS time. It also, and this is something that's good for everybody, is that it rids the body of xenoestrogens. And we've heard a lot about those in the news. And what they are, those are man-made chemicals that mimic estrogen. And what they can do, they usually cause weight gain, PMS symptoms, trigger early menopause, cause men to have breasts. So all of these things, these xenoestrogens that are man-made, will cause us to get into our system. So we want to remove those. The DIM will do that. You find them, you say, well, how do you get all those xenoestrogens in your body? Where do they come from? Jennifer, they're everywhere. Mm-hmm. They use them to fatten up livestock. They use them in plastic bottles, especially if you have a plastic bottle that's with a water bottle that's been sitting in the sunshine. It releases that mm-hmm. into the water. They're found in the lining of cans. Canned food liners have the xenoestrogens in them. Nail polish remover, most cosmetics, car exhaust, cleaning supplies. So we are bombarded with xenoestrogens everywhere. And so we wonder why our daughters are starting having their cycles at 7 or 8 now. They've just gotten so much estrogens in their body, it's kind of tricked their body and thinking, okay, it's time to do this. And boys are having more acne cases. Acne in both young men and women are caused by having too much estrogen in your body.
And amazing to think that even though some of these are newer things, some of the things that our culture has created, yet God created way back at the beginning of time the natural supplements that could be needed to help reverse these things.
Right, and it's the cruciferous vegetables are not popular vegetables. If someone's going to eat, they're going to have corn or maybe green beans. But if you're eating cruciferous vegetables on a regular basis, and that's cabbage family, cabbage, broccoli, cauliflower, kale, radishes, all of those are wonderful cruciferous vegetables that carry this DIM in them, which will help you control your extra estrogen in your body. So getting back to good, healthy diets, eating all the foods that God gave us, will make a difference in our body.
Excellent.
We're always thankful for Dr. Trudy here at TV 44. What you may not know is that before Dr. Trudy became a doctor, she helped nonprofit organizations with major fundraising projects. TV 44 first met Dr. Trudy during the Transforming Lives Capital campaign, which allowed us to transition into digital high-definition broadcasting. So as you might find yourself thanking Dr. Trudy for her medical wisdom, you can also thank her for her dedication to Christian organizations like ours, an important factor in your ability to even watch us on TV today. And with that, we are out of time for this week's show. Know that we're praying for you this week. We encourage you to continue your commitment to the 2017 Faith Challenge. Read your Bible every day. Find time to talk to God in prayer every day. And be willing to search your heart and mind for unresolved issues. Take those issues before the Lord. Repentance, an important step to freedom, and we all need to experience inner freedom. There's no better way to achieve that than a true relationship with Jesus. Until next week, for Jennifer, Mark, and myself, thanks for joining us this week on Faith and Friends.